Further south, Albion has a white sand beach, in contrast to the region of the lighthouse. Here, fishing not only feeds the inhabitants, but is also under experimentation by technicians of the research center. Higher up, birds have hung their nests on top of giant palm trees. Just as a peacock that majestically extends its feathers in the rays of the sun. We continue our way towards the south, crossing sugarcane fields that extend as far as the eyes can see. Following the sun leads us through the endless fields to the sea of Flikaflak. A magical, marvelous beach facing an azure blue sea. And there, under a flower wood, dozens of holidaymakers are having a picnic. Here is a good place to swim. A large swimming pool where the warmth of the water makes you forget time. The big waves keep well away from the lagoon. Here, the weaver bird is imitated by the red whiskered bulbul in its acrobatics to pick the acacia. We resume our trip in a region dried by the sun. The great number of tamarind trees showing off the bittersweet fruits, delicious for a marvelous fruit squash, suddenly attracts our gaze. It is from that fruit that our next stop gets its name, tamarind. The tamarind mountain dominates this quiet little village. From the slope of the mountain, you can admire the salt pans where salt harvesters are working. The production of table salt has created jobs for the inhabitants of the neighborhood. The beach of Tamarin is somewhat different because of its grayish color. Fishermen here live at the same rhythm as yesterday, slapping cards or playing the guitar. Waves break to the great joy of surfers, In the past, slave villages where the sega resounded from one village to another, while the four-beat waltz is today's rhythm. The small idyllic beach of La Pronos, restful, desert and calm. The place takes its name from the frigate La Pronos, which came to defy the English in the calm waters of the bay. From here, there is an unrestricted view of Le Morne Mountain at the extreme southwest of Mauritius. La Pronos still shelters today, after 170 years, one of the martyr towns that the English erected on the island to repulse the invader. Today it has been renovated and converted into a museum. The tower has an efficient defense system with two cannons on top that pivot over 360 degrees to protect the large bay of Rivière Noire. Under the enormous banyan tree of Casnoyal, sea workers have left their cycles to have a little chat, telling about their adventures at sea.